Hey, Spuddies! Potato McWhiskey here, and welcome back to Civilization VI as Rome. We're playing as Julius Caesar, and we are farming gold from these barb camps, my dude. We are making the money. We definitely need to get shipbuilding, but we also need to get all these districts down. Make sure we have all the right tiles and all the right cities. You're getting a harbor. Theoretically, I could swap. Nah. You'll get a harbor. That's fine. Okay. Not gonna swap any of those doodly boops around. Doodly boop is distinct from a scoodly poop. And I think the general plan this game is to just, you know, keep the momentum. I'm not going to harvest these sheep tiles. I have not yet unlocked plantations. I may have a little think about this here. Production is king. So I want to get production. Long-term development of this city, okay? Long-term development of Rome will almost certainly involve what? Well, I could theoretically decide to settle a city here. It wouldn't be a very productive city, but it would be able to get a harbor and a campus here, which is fine. And then I suppose if I were to put a bath there, that would be fine. Oh, there's no river for the bath to connect to. So I can't get a bath in my capital. So that's something I should consider. I don't know if I'll settle there then. Unfortunate positioning. I guess, dare I move my commercial hub a tile in exchange for getting a bath? It does not feel particularly good to lose two adjacency on this just to get a bath. Now, I mean, the bath is good. It's for housing and an amenity. But just how much work, like use, am I going to get out of that? I think we might just forego a bath in our capital and we'll focus on that elsewhere. We do have an interesting location here. Definitely want to get that camp online. Puteoli could go for an industrial zone. Like, it's a pretty decent one. Like, let's say hypothetically we did this. Unfortunately, I don't think a dam will go on this tile. Yeah, because it has to be touching two sides of the river. We could theoretically, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This would still hit the capital if I were to place this one. If we eventually conquer Leventa, it would hit Leventa as well, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, it would. So we could do this in Puteoli to get that going. I think that's part of our plans. I think growing to 7 population in the capital will be relatively important. I'll go ahead and get that fishing tile online. I'm not going to harvest or destroy these because that's just extra builder charges for things that aren't production. I'll harvest the forests for sure. Where it makes sense. I've got 1,000 gold in the bank, which is something I should really have a little bit of a think about. I'm going to attack with my spearmen and get me a bit of XP. Didn't mean to attack with a warrior there. That was actually a mistake. I think I'm going to go ahead and buy myself an archer and send this archer to replace, and then send this archer to reinforce over here, get it onto this hill. It'll shoot this barb camp. We'll be able to get control of it. It's a lot of gold to spend, but I think it's a reasonable amount considering the return on investment there. Right, so we just got state workforce, which means in the capital, I can place the government plaza. I think I'm going to go ahead and harvest the granary here and then take... I can't harvest rice yet. Right, I made a bit of a mistake there. So I'll have to get irrigation first. That's fine. We can spend a few turns on a warrior. No, that's a low value target. We'll just put a few turns into a builder. I don't think I care about promoting Pingala or Magnus anymore, do I? Well, we are going to be doing internal trade routes, so surplus logistics is quite good here. That's 20% extra growth in the capital. Actually, that 20% extra growth in the capital has now made me realize that I am going to build a bath and I'm going to build a commercial hub here. So that will allow me to grow a much more big, like a bigger capital with a lot of districts, which is the plan here. Is to just get a ton of districts in my capital. So to that end, we're going to need a lot of food in here. And we don't have a lot of tiles for food, actually. There is a farm triangle over here that I can feed my capital with. I'll just have to keep giving it lots of tiles and keep it on the up and up. Oh, we found Lake Victoria. It's a 4-tile natural wonder, appears as a lake and provides fresh water. Yields 3 food, 1 culture and 1 gold. Could be a good one to try and settle. We'll go ahead and get the next city down. Ostia, welcome to the party. You are going to do what? Well, you're going to hard build a granary while I purchase a monument, because we're not ready yet to place down our districts. We may as well spend that gold that we have. Another barb camp down here. We could theoretically get on board the farming train. Badger Claw Clan. Oh, I could hire an archer from that. It would be quite nice to hire an archer, actually. Do I want to chop here? No, we want to wait. I will put a mine here because it's +1 production in the short term. So the trick with the galley is that I believe galleys have 3 movement and quadriremes have 3. So the trick with the galley is to step forward twice and then step back, because that means you will be able to see a galley and then step out of its range. Because let's say there's a galley here. If I step forward twice and then step back, most of the time it's not going to come and attack me. A much more safer way to do it is, if you're really concerned about losing a ship, is to only step 1 tile at a time. But I also have Norwegian ships in the area kind of helping me out, so I'm not too worried about that. So 1, 2, and then back. All right, we've got a little bit of a problem down here with unit spawning. Another Leventa chariot has come to say hi. Shouldn't be too hard to drive him off. It's the one downside of Marathon is that you take a lot of actions and then not a lot happens. Okay, I think we can get this quadrarium kill, and as long as there's no more barbarian boats around, we will promote and get a heal on this guy, and then we'll be in basically full control of this. Right, chariot should die, and then we can return to our plans. We'll get the pasture online. These are resources we can sell to the AI. Now, I will be selling horses. I will endeavor not to sell my iron. Because I want to get legions. Actually, I might go like irrigation, writing, ironworking to start getting legions. Okay, we got a little quadrarium spawning. This guy's actually fought so many barbs. He's almost level 3, which is quite exciting. It is pillage turn. So let's refill the coffers. Boom, boom, boom. And boom. Slightly awkward position. We'll have to step back with that archer. So this eagle warrior will get bounced to this trial. And then we pillage. So we just refilled 2,000 gold. Shall we purchase ourselves a settler, or shall we do something else with our gold? I think we've bought all of our monuments, right? Yeah, we have. You could justify a granary. You could justify a builder in here as well to improve all these fishing tiles. If we take a look at what the city's actually working, I'm going to give this food tile to Rome, and I'm going to lock it in too because I want that food. I want the city to grow, grow, grow. But yeah, locking in a bunch of fishing tiles here would be very helpful, I think. So, but the city is building a builder, so I don't need to do that. I think the thing to do is to continue to expand. Like, the more settlers we get, the faster we hit our tempo. Because now, right, we divide this by 30, we are on par. So usually my benchmark for having a really good game is if you can get a city every 10 turns, right? On Marathon speed, that's a city every 30 turns. You're doing amazing. If you get a city out every 10 turns on a standard speed game, you're doing really well. And by getting this fifth city out, now we're on pace. Now remember, our build is still accelerating. So we're still going to get faster and faster. The question is, do I chop and then build the camp? I think I build the camp. Kill you and kill you, softening them up. Use our archer for this. You chase him, you kill there. You come forward, new archer arrived. Go ahead and clear him out. Perfect. Archer assists. We kill that guy. Now we're in control of the camp again. And we'll get big money in another 10 turns. Oh, right. I got to clear this camp as well. Whoops. Yeah, sometimes I'm forgetful. So we just unlocked writing. So I can place my government plaza here. Perfect. So that's that sheep tile dead. Or that rice tile dead. Do I want to place my campus now, or do I want to wait? Well, this is a 2 production tile, and if I were to take that, I wouldn't have another 2 production tile to work. So we'll play it slow and we'll play it safe, at least until we can maybe find production for the city of Rome. Something I can definitely do in my capital in order to enable the city's growth is to get a harbor, because that would make these fishing tiles very valuable for it. In particular, the crabs, right? And the coastal potential is there too. Got to be thinking about the long-term benefits. I suppose, what if I moved these over to a different city? My capital is just going to be so busy. Ostia is the newer city, so maybe we'll actually build it in Ostia. I think I like this configuration way better, although I do need to keep in mind that that was positioned for city overlap, wasn't it? I mean, this is still really good city overlap right here. That's currently a 5 city overlap, could potentially be a 6, maybe a 7 city overlap on this bad boy, which is a really, really good Colosseum. If you're wondering what the Colosseum does and why I'm building it, it's because it gives you +2 culture and +2 amenities, but that applies to every single city center within 6 tiles of the Colosseum. And similarly, the entertainment complex later on in the game will also provide bonus amenities. So I'd love to get the Colosseum this game if I could. And I think I have the tempo to maybe pull it off. All right, builder online in the capital. Let's get the plantation. Nice chunk of extra gold. We'll go ahead and get started on that government plaza. And we're now working on legions, which is great. Ooh, a new barb camp appeared down here. That's huge, actually. I'll start making the army required to go deal with that. Probably the second I raid all these. Right, boom. There's our fifth city settled. Ravenna, welcome to the fold. You do have a decent campus location right here. If I'm looking at the city of Ravenna, how am I going to make it a powerhouse? Well, I guess there's going to be farms going here, I think. Well, this will actually be a bath. Definitely want to build as many baths as I can because they give pretty good return on investment. Ravenna is well positioned for a harbor, in my opinion. Now, the question is, where do I want to put that harbor? I think I put it here. And then this is also a campus city. And I think, you know, harbor, campus, theater square, that's Ravenna sorted. I don't need any more buildings in there. Why don't you hard build me a granary so that you can grow? And we'll buy your okay, there's the chop for the government plaza. Let's go ahead and place the campus now. I hate to crush a sheep tile like that. But I don't really have much of a choice. It does hurt the production of my capital. But yeah, we're going to go for the granary first because we have a lot of potential for vertical growth. Now, thinking about what my next governor is going to be, I do feel like a Pingala second governor is appropriate here. I'm trying to think which of my cities has the best growth potential. It is my capital, but that's where Magnus is going. Maybe it's actually Ravenna. I think Ravenna might be a good place for Pingala long term. Short term, it's not amazing. But long term, there's like a huge amount of growth potential in this city between the sugar, between the crabs, between the fish. This is probably the most optimal place to have Pingala long term. Definitely not short term, but long term, yes. So we just boosted apprenticeship by building our third mine. That'll get us a step closer towards industrial zones. And it is pillage turn now as well. I don't like this. This Grand Colombian Spearman hanging out nearby is not cool. He's like a third, fifth, fourth wheel. Whichever level of wheel he wants to be, that's what he is. So we just got 2,000 gold in the bank. I think the play is to hire a pair of archers. This will also become a city-state soon. And send those down to conquer this barb camp. And then if I hire a warrior, it'll take about 30 turns of pillaging for these guys to get a return on investment. So yeah, I spent about 1,000 gold on that, but like, you know, I'm also getting a monument in here. Like my culture tempo is really, really strong. My science tempo should pick up too. I'm going to wait a turn to see if Bolivar attacks. We've got a builder in here. Let's go ahead and build the plantation. 32 versus 18 or 35 versus 23. I think my warrior gets slightly better damage. So we'll have the warrior in position. More hoplite spawning. Might be a good idea to hire an eagle warrior and send it against Leventa. We could start just having two eagle warriors sitting outside Leventa. I think that actually might be what I do here. Is if I have a couple of eagle warriors just sitting outside Leventa, I can just spawn builders from the kills, which seems pretty damn powerful. So the Grand Colombian Spearmen attacked like I expected, so we can take back control of the Yellow Goat clan. We never, ever, ever want to give control of a city-state to another civ. That is a big no-no. I fought too hard for these damn... Or I call them city-states. They're barb camps. I fought too hard for these damn barb camps. They will belong to me, damn it. Got a guy in position in Puteoli. We'll buy this tile and then we'll chop to finish the granary. Well, the granary won't quite be finished, but we'll get close. And then we'll place the campus. But we'll finish the granary first because we want the city. We want our cities to grow because they can work more tiles. If they can work more tiles, we get more yields. Therefore, we get more tempo. Nice. So we have access to the Legion. Unfortunately, we don't have anyone nearby that we can kill. However, we are playing on marathon game speed. So it is possible for us to send units pretty far away from the homeland. Go ahead and give me a bit of cash. I'm going to sell off a little bit of iron too. Although he doesn't really want to buy much iron. We'll leave the iron. Any open borders enjoyers? Oh, I think there is. So we could theoretically send some legions to Bogota here. And I think getting a legion seems kind of exciting and fun. Now he has a bill charge that I can make use of. I know I'm pronouncing Bogota really like weird. I've heard people say it. I don't know how to say it. I don't understand how to make those noises with my mouth. Okay, I have a... Is this marsh? I have a weak pronunciation ability, okay? It's not my strong suit. So where am I sending this legion? It's an interesting question. I think I send the legion down here to control this barb camp with an archer. I send the eagles to farm units from Leventa, ideally. That way we can get free builders. Little gentle old eruption down here causing some issues, but not anything we can't deal with. Is this the end of turn glitch? I'm once again asking the developers to fix the end of turn glitch. Oh, man. Right, here we go. Right, so turn reloaded, government unlocked, and end of turn bug averted, it seems. Now, in terms of our government pick here, we have a couple of valid choices. Oligarchy for Rome feels like the natural ally. You know, getting that +4 combat strength on our legions can really extend their combat prowess. Yeah, I mean, if we look at that, it would be +44 combat strength. 44 combat strength is like, that's like on par with a... Jesus, did they actually buff these things? I don't remember them being 40 combat strength, but 40 is a lot. Like, that's on par with a man at arms if I plug in oligarchy. And when you say it like that, that makes it sound really damn good. So let's go for oligarchy. This allows me to plug in discipline and conscription. We will keep urban planning in. I may as well plug in ilkum, although there could be something to be said for some of these other ones. But you know, I will be building builders at various times throughout this next phase of the game. I can upgrade my Aztec Eagle Warriors into Legions too. I think I'll keep them as Eagle Warriors for a very simple reason. is that they have that special ability to capture enemy units. Now, they're not as strong as legions, but they're pretty close, right? Like 32 combat strength is like respectable. That's almost like a swordsman. Whose horse is that right there? That's 3 food, 2 production. Lovely. Now, do I want to get the cattle tile online or do I want to focus on the food? I think I'm going to get the cattle tile online because that is a production tile and production is king in this game. We'll go ahead and get the granary. We will place the campus to lock in its price, but we will build the granary right now. I'm going to send you to go guard this camp and you're heading over here to Leventa. We do have control of the Stone Kite clan. This turn is technically pillage turn, but I'm going to delay it one turn for the purpose of synchronizing everyone together. I'm okay with that tiny delay. I'm going to kill this quad right here. Get that nice fishing boat. That's a 4 food, 1 production, 1 gold tile. Like you'd be hard pressed to find a tile better than that. So I could level up this archer again. He almost has double attacks, honestly. So I'm going to take emplacement and then this guy's going to pillage and we can come do. And we should end up with about 2,400 gold at least based on all of this pillaging. We do a little attacking. You're clear. Right, you head here. The first thing we're going to do is definitely buy an eagle. Oh, it's a swordsman now. It was eagle warriors, but that does mean swordsmen are going to start spawning. Man-at-arms as well. Jesus. Okay, that's a very... very early man-at-arms. There must be a there has to be a Babylon in the game. That's a classical era man-at-arms, way earlier than they should ever be in the game. So the real question is, do I want to go ahead and attack? No, I don't. See, I'd like to save up my cash for a couple more settlers. I could hire more galleys. I don't care about galleys. What do we got in terms of hiring here? I mean, hiring a man-at-arms would be kind of fun. It's only a tiny bit stronger than my legions, though. That's the thing. Would have loved to have gotten a second Eagle Warrior. That would have been really nice. You, however, you're becoming a legion. And we'll need to get our hands on a battering ram soon. So that we can kill Leventa. Okay, there's military tradition giving us flanking and support combat bonuses. Which will make our life a little bit easier when it comes to war. We did kill a unit from Leventa, capturing ourselves a builder. Which was the plan all along. You step here. Perfect. You've got it under control. So now that we have military tradition, we want to think about what the next phase of the game has for us. And it's probably going to be heading towards feudalism to get our hands on the settler policy card, the builder policy card, serfdom. And we're also going to be mainly using the gold from these barb camps that we're constantly pillaging to continue to develop our empire, right? To make a huge, massive amount of cities, which I think is our main goal. Is to just build the most giga huge, omega massive empire imaginable. There is a universe in which we could consider attacking another player. Theoretically, we could get the Bogota, but I think honestly, the ability for us to just sim here is powerful enough for us to just stay here and do that. And what I mean by sim is basically where you just don't do any war, and you build improvements, you build districts, you improve your empire, you go for early granaries to grow really tall so you can get your districts placed early. Speaking of placing districts early, that's your only production tile, so that's something we have to be a little bit concerned about in Ravenna, is there's a big lack of production in Ravenna. So, Legion, go ahead and chop that. There we go, that's the granary finished. Now, we're not going for a campus in here, so we will put a few turns into a builder. We use the Legion chop, so we'll go ahead and send him somewhere. I reckon... if we started upgrading a few more legions, we won't need quite as many units guarding all of these barbarian camps, which would allow us to start to send, consider a military adventure. I think our main military adventure is going to be against Leventa first. So our build is probably going to look something like going for currency so that we can get our trade routes down, then going for masonry so that we can harvest stone, build walls, and most importantly, build a battering ram to kill Leventa. And then we're going to head for shipbuilding so we can start to embark and potentially look into maybe killing some more city-states, like the one that's spawning down here. We might want to kill this one. Things, just things for us to consider as part of our long-term plan is just be a bit of a warmonger and make use of the abilities that the game has given us. So where am I going to settle down here? I could settle coastally here. It wouldn't be a bad city. It's got like actually pretty decent tiles. I think maybe a more interesting settlement is right here because then I can bath to this tile and then industrial zone there. Sorry, I should be bathing to here. And then this is a +7 industrial zone. This is a +3 that'll eventually become a +5, which is a pretty damn good industrial zone. This also basically clinches out this southern area. And then I could probably settle somewhere down here just to finish this off. Now, if I wanted to be super optimal, I could fit 3 more cities in here, but I'm just going to spread them out slightly. So I think a legion and an archer is sufficient for most camps now. I reckon that's what I'll try and have at every place. I'd love to be able to, like, I would love if I hovered over this ranged attack button, it would show me which tiles this archer could attack. Like, like the actual attack range. And then I'd love if I could, like, right-click it and then hover over, like, oh, if I was standing here, which tiles could I attack? There's this sort of, there's something about not being able to tell where my attacks could potentially land. That kind of irks me a bit when I'm playing around with range units. Right, we have a build charge in here. I reckon we can chop this jungle as well, because we're about to be ready to drop the commercial hub on it. Tortoise is really quite powerful, but I find Commando actually tends to be very strong. And then if you can get Urban Warfare, that like completely changes how this unit plays in city environments. Nice first campus with really high adjacency, getting us +3 era score. That's the one in the capital finishing. I reckon Ancestral Hall is the meta for this Rome game. Then again, Rome is a natural conqueror, especially Julius Caesar. Yeah, so I think I'll go for Warlord's Throne. And that's purely just because now when I conquer a city, not only will I get gold, I'll get a 20% production boost across my entire city, which, by the way, is equivalent to having +5 amenities in every city, at least for production. So let's go ahead and get the pillage turn on with. Wake up, baby. New pillage turn just dropped. So that is everything pillaged. We've got 3,000 gold in the bank. And again, it just feels like a natural move to just continue to buy settlers. This legion can almost single-handedly clear this camp. It actually did single-handedly clear the camp, and so did this bad boy right here. So who's got a build charge? You've got a build charge. So I'm going to chop here and then place that commercial hub. We'll go improve that mine. Do you know, I think if Julius Caesar can make this much money off barb camps, I feel like it would be fine if the Aztecs had a small chance, just a small chance, to turn barb units into builders. I think that would be fair. Do I want to send a settler far forward to forward settle Grand Columbia? It's not the worst idea in the world. I guess we'll drop a city center here, that's for sure. That's a pretty decent spot. It's got a bunch of foxes and it's also another canal. Do I need another canal? First things first, let's try to identify really good district locations. Now, we don't really have a whole lot. I guess here is fine because we'll get the okay harbor. I do a little bit of a search for reef. Yeah, and then that's a natural campus location there, obviously. And then theoretically, if I settled on this iron and then I put a harbor here, a campus here, that's quite good. Very science and gold heavy build we've got here. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So there's not much room here for much overlap. There's an okay city right here. Similar sort of build up. So there's a very unorthodox build here where I'm going for a harbors and stuff. I think I should get an encampment actually. Or maybe I should buy a great general for my legions. Something to think about. It is 3,000 gold. Maybe we'll get her on the next go around. So you've used your build charge. You can be sent to the west. Let's go ahead and buy the settler that we were planning. We'll drop a mine right there. Constantly dealing with a wave of barbarians. But this, honestly, this feels like how Julius Caesar is supposed to play. You're supposed to probably be up against like dozens and dozens and dozens of barbs. Now, I feel like if Julius Caesar was a Crusader Kings character, he'd have that thriving in chaos ability. I suppose there's no harm in moving Magnus to Ostia in the short term. Because I'll be able to make some builder charge stuff work in here when I start to go for the entertainment complex. I'll probably chop out the Colosseum to try and get it. It's a ton of amenities. It's a ton of culture. It'll really put me back on par with the AI. Yeah, like that trade route to Rome is really strong. 3 food, 2 production. But I'm going to go ahead and put it in Ostia first. Interestingly enough, Norway is spreading Islam to me. Is that actually a religion of relevance here? Not really. He did get a good pantheon, Gurdwaras, and made purchase buildings for faith. Yeah, not a big deal. So I want Ostia to trade with Rome to get that extra growth and production, to get that city up in terms of population, but also up in terms of production, just raw production, so that we can start the entertainment complex sooner. I tell you what though, the game is so much slower when you play on marathon game speed. Like, you know, that probably sounds obvious, like, yeah, duh, potato, the game is slower, like, yeah, well done. But just like, it's actually just insane. Like, it's crazy slow. So we're going to chop in Rome. This will finish the Warlord's Throne sooner, take 8 turns off, and then we can just put a mine back on that tile. I'm a big fan of shopping. Next turn I can get myself another legion, which I'm looking forward to. Every new legion is I might actually declare war on Simon Bolivar and start pillaging him, because I don't think he can do anything against my legions. My legions are so souped up. If I just do another pillage turn and recruit Boudica, I actually think there's fuck all he can do to me. So Leventa hates me. I do want to be friends with Hunza, because Hunza is actually quite good. +1 gold for every 5 tiles of your trade routes travel. That's going to be really, really nice, because trading is a really big part of Rome's gameplay. Let's start the pillage turn off on the right foot. We got some big pillages going. Was that all of them? It doesn't feel like that much gold. I guess 2,500 gold, you know, while a lot, when you're playing on Marathon, it doesn't feel that much. My Legion got kicked out of the Barb camp, but I don't know where he went. Right, let's activate the unit list. So I know about this Legion. I know about this Legion. I know about this Legion. Oh, I think my Legion just got deleted. I'm going to go ahead and not accept that. That seems like a bug to me, because I have three Legions and I should have four. And I think I know what happened. So what I think happened here is because there's no tile within two tiles of this Barb camp to kick my Legion to, it just deleted my Legion. Because yeah, look, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 Legions in this iteration of the save file. So I think the game is just a little bit buggy. We won't let that stop us from doing a pillage turn though. Not a chance. And so reloads in the case of like that, typically I'm usually okay with a reload. If the reload is happening as a result of a lack of game knowledge, not like, oh, I didn't know that Arabia had knights. No, like, oh, I literally didn't know that if there's not enough tiles for a unit to get kicked to, the unit just gets actually deleted. So that kind of game knowledge is what I'm talking about. So rather than build something in Ostia, I'm just going to force end turn because we're starting the entertainment complex next turn. Oh, did I forget to clean up my mess? I think I did. A couple of places I forgot to do what I was supposed to do. We'll get it sorted. Okay, Barb camp cleared. So we were going to go ahead and lay down the entertainment complex. I want to save the gold to finish that, but we'll start chopping. Slow and casual chops. I got my granary in here. I'm not building a commercial hub. So I need to get engineering. I need to get shipbuilding. I need to get celestial navigation. I need to get mathematics. I just need like all of these techs. My empire is very like broad. I think shipbuilding would make the world smaller for me. I'd love to start laying down harbors. I'm at the phase of the game where that's like a consideration. Let's get another legion to send to the front line with Grand Columbia. Now, I'd also wanted to build a battering ram to deal with Leventa, but I think that's kind of like on the back burner ideas right now. Right now, I'd like to try and get efficient damage on Simon Bolivar. So when we break a tile, we put a mine on it. I want to up the tile's productivity. That's probably a good idea. I'll have to do another cycle. I'll have to do another cycle of pillaging to make that happen. But I guess I will buy a builder in this city and then wait for the next cycle of chopping. And then I'll be able to buy a great general. I'm surprised that these city states, when they event, like these barb camps, when they eventually become city states, I'll be surprised if they want to be my friend. The amount of times I've killed them. I may as well use this chop to force growth in this city. That brought you up to 2 turns from growing. Perfect. All right, little Grand Colombian spearman. Let's see what you've got. Apparently not much because you've like just taken the absolute worst position now. Did my denouncement run out? Oh, I never actually denounced him in this version of the game because I had to reload that turn. Right. Ooh, a free settler. If I can block him a little bit or even just kill it. Oh, he already settled it. Damn. He's got that movement. Good news is pillage turn in 2 turns. Pillage turn feels like Christmas. I'm not going to lie. I mean, it is coming up to Christmas, IRL. But pillage turn really feels like Christmas. So what I would like to do is I'm going to buy this tile in Puteoli. Then I'm going to come into Ostia. And then I'll swap over here. And I buy it in Puteoli because it was cheaper to buy it in Puteoli. If you really simple demonstration here. Here is a... How do I demonstrate this game mechanic? I think it's pretty simple, right? If I had bought this tile over here in the city of Ostia, it would have cost me 360 because it would have been a third ring tile. But because I bought it in Puteoli, it was only 240 cost. And now I can place this campus or this commercial hub, and then I can just re-swap back the tiles. And now, really interesting consequence of this is if I go to the Empire map mode, there is an island. Like Ostia just owns like this little enclave. Purely for the purpose of this government plaza. So, you know, it is possible to do this sort of stuff to get giga efficiency around your government plaza. So always think about this kind of like configuration, like if it's a possible move. And usually if it is possible, it's something that can be worth doing. Right, pillage turn is upon us. But not only is it pillage turn, it's great general turn. A very rare and exciting turn. I just barely can't afford her. I can buy her next turn. I don't know where I'm getting all this gold from. I guess my cities just make big money. I'll take a little bit of cash from Harald Hardrada so that I can buy Boudicca. kind of an interesting thing. I'm pretty sure Boudica was like one of the people who fought the Romans, and I'm using Boudica now as the Romans. Kind of a fun little turn of events there. Cute. I wish I knew more about history so that I could talk about like the cute little idiosyncrasies that like pop up when you're playing games like Civ. Boudica will take a while to get to the front line. Can I declare war on Civ? Oh yeah, we could do a form of war now. And so declaring war actually found me Auckland. Let's go ahead and renew our friendship with Norway. We'll send him a delegation. We'll make him a deal. If he declares war on Simon Bolivar, will you do this for a single gold? He will. I love the one gold go to war exploit. It's like my favorite. Capturing an enemy city grants a 20% bonus production in all cities for 5 turns. Now it is only 5 turns, but what if I capture the city and then just let it flip back to him? Like, I don't care. Like, I just capture it and let it go. Would that be a bit evil of me? There's a ton of stuff in here for us to pillage too, and I don't think he can do anything about legions. I don't think he's really... He might be close to crossbows. It's about the time of the game that he would get crossbows, I think. But I am genuinely skeptical that he can do anything against us here. He's building walls in Caracas. Let's see if we can put the city under siege. I think if we step here, the city's now officially under siege. So any damage we do to the city is permanent. And we can start to level up these legions by attacking Caracas over and over again. I'll probably capture it and then maybe try to piece him out with it, because I can just attack him over and over again. So I don't want to raise the city. I probably want to capture it and then try to sell it back to him. And be like, hey, look, I took your city, bud. Would you like to give me money in exchange for the city? Or I could just delete it and eat the grievances. I really don't want to eat the grievances is the thing. Right, so we took over the city. I'd say we just keep it for a couple of turns. See if he'll buy it back from us tomorrow or like next turn. Yeah, it would be good to get mathematics to get our Diplo Quarter. That's going to be part of our long-term play for the capital. The capital did build Warlord's Throne this turn, so we should see. We're getting the 20% production boost here, which is really nice. That's like a 20% tempo boost. It's like getting an extra turn of production. Now, do I want to go harbor or commercial hub here in the capital? If I place the commercial hub, I completely tank the capital's production. That's why I'm a little bit leery to do it this early. So I'll probably go harbor first. I need to place my harbor in Mediolanum as well, so we'll get that down. And also, capturing the city got me money. Now, it's important to note that it's 200 gold whenever you conquer a city for the first time, or 100 gold when you gain gold from a barb camp. So let's go ahead and take Connoisseur on Pingala for the extra culture. I need the culture. And the reason you go for culture on Pingala is because that extra culture that Pingala gets you will unlock more governor titles faster, and, you know, because they're unlocked in the culture tree. And more governor titles is more better. More betterer. Right, Simon, what kind of peace would you take? Oh, he doesn't want peace. All right, I can't declare peace because we are at war. It's a fresh war, that's right. I suppose I'll just send this guy to go pillage that farm for a heal and then see what else we can do to him. We can finally place the harbor in here. This is its literal only production tile, so I really don't want to kill it for our campus yet. But we can get started on our districts now, which is really, really nice. And plus, we have a great general on the front line with Simon Bolivar. So we will be doing damage in this war. How much and what kind of impact that'll have on the game? Well, that's an open question. Yeah, I think we just let this flip. We try to get in here and start pillaging all these juicy tiles. So we have our campus complete. The question is, do we want to go for the library now? While libraries are quite good, I think the trade route actually technically gets us more tempo, especially as Rome with the extra gold on internal trade routes. So we'll go for the commercial hubs first. Plus, we have a lot of gold and we can buy libraries. If we just manage to get enough gold from like doing these silly meme things with our units, then I think that's the play. Looks like a Toa spawned and the city flipped, but I'm out of there. Don't care. Spearmen and two warriors. Ooh, I think I recorded a little bit too long in this video. I think it was partially because I had a crash early on in the video, but I'm going to go ahead and leave you guys there. We have made significant progress. We managed to get out 2 more cities. We made a really big empire, and this is only the beginning. I love you all very much, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.